Welcome to the channel of A172 Purchasing Management and Supply Chain. I'm Suomin from Group A.
I am Asna from Group B. We would like to report the news about what has been happened along this semester in this subject, which is Purchasing Management and Supply Chain.
For your information, the students have been divided into two classes, which is Class A and Class B, under the guidance of our lecturer, Dr. Aidan B. Mohammad Saifuddin, and there are 10 groups of members which form by different races and gender.
Let's watch the video.
Dr. Aidan gave the first impression to me when I first time entered the class.
How are you?
Dr. Aidan is a very strict person.
How are you?
I hear a lot of seniors say Dr. Aidan is a very strict lecturer, not same like other lecturers. So you better change your attitude.
Okay. Yeah. I takut nanti I jadi boring. You know? Masalah apa kamu ada?
And my first impression of him, I thought he was like a cute guy because he got the dimple beside the cheek. But when start the second class, I realized I was wrong because he is quite strict.
Company, I want the best for you. Kau tak ada question ni?
On the 16th of March 2018, a site visit to Gano Excel has been carried out for the project assignment. To know more about the activities during the site visit, watch the videos.
Hello! Assalamualaikum!
And a very good morning!
So today we are going to
Gano Excel! Company busy.
Yeah.
Bye-bye. Welcome to purchasing trip. Alamak.
Hello guys, so
hello.
We are at Gano Excel for today company visit.
So for more information, let's check it out.
Woo! Oh my god.
Okay, come, go to the lobby now.
Hello everyone. Sekarang ni kita orang dekat Gano Discovery Center.
What's the solution?
We learn from previous time.
So some of this is.
Hello. So we are done for our company visit.
So let's go back and set up our assignment.
Yoo! Good luck, guys. Okay.
to visit Sukarno Excel, the student are asked to write the report of the project assignment based on information from the visit. They have captured a precious moment by taking selfie during their meeting. To report what's going on now.
Hi guys, so now we are waiting outside Dr. Adam's room to submit our report, so let's go now.
Selamat sejuta insan gelap dalam matahari insan juga bisa insaf mana cerita panglima yang wujud benar awang hitam kaji awan putih bila berlayar membuat keliling dunia tuannya yang terkenal dah merdeka di jasad harus bebas di akal
hatiku tetap hanya padamu kerana aku berdiri
kamu cita-cita hanya kekal sebagai mimpi semuanya bermula dari sini
negaraku negaraku beri sepenuhnya ku beri sepenuhnya demi negaraku oh daraku hiduplah sepenuhnya dirgayu semua
dan dari 57 jalannya telah disuluh bangkit seakan subuh rebung di lentur bulu terus ke 63 kami menjadi kita jangan dipersia akibat titik-titik nilai tiap hujan batu turun selebat tengkujung selagi kami mampu semangat tak pernah lumpuh selagi ada tubuh untuk kamu aku memburu saya aku bubur semua petir tiada guru
hatiku tetap hanya padamu kerana aku
tanpamu cita-cita hanya kekal sebagai mimpi semuanya bermula dari sini
negaraku negara
Negaraku, negaraku, ku beri sebuah
awaited by everyone has been arrived, which is Delivery Day.
Delivery Day was held on the 4th of May 2018 at Dewan Seminar C. Let's see what happened on the day.
Vegan. My name is Azra and I'm come from Indonesia. First of all, I would like to say thank you to Dr. Adam as our course instructor.
I would like to thank Dr. Adam for giving me this opportunity to become the project manager.
I just want to thank you, Doctor, my favorite doctor, and Dr. Adam. I just want to say that I learned a lot from your class. I've been through a lot being the project manager for this class.
Although Dr. Adam is a very strict lecturer, but he also is a very good lecturer because he shares a lot of knowledge to us and helps us to guide us in order to make sure we finish our project.
I know that what he wants us to achieve is good for us.
It's been a hard time during the purchasing class without a doubt, but all the activity is to nurture us to become the better person.
I have learned such as the bonding and the skills that I've been through in your class, such as the leading skills and the bonding between agribusiness and operation management students.
And I still remember what he taught us in the first class, saying our student must have a force us to become a better man. So that was really impressed me.
I'm happy to meet new friends in this class and I hope we won't forget each other.
I'm very appreciative for your effort to help us and to overcome our problem, no matter it's a life problem or assignment problem. You also, like our fathers, lead us step by step until we succeed. Without light, we cannot go through darkness.
The purchasing class did not only taught us about the theoretical, but also a lesson in life, a lesson that we won't get elsewhere.
To others, you may be just a lecturer, but for us, you are the reason for us to work hard and motivated.
So I hope that there are more people like you in this world, because you are kind.
And last, I would like to thank my core team for giving us hard a commitment during the meeting and event.
I hope that after finish your class in this semester, I can transform myself from input to output, become more knowledgeable.
And it's almost time for us to part ways, and I'm hoping for the best to us all in the future. And see you again.
Assalamualaikum, warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Very special morning to all my beloved the BJMP 3073 Purchasing Management and Supply Chain students. How are you today? I'm very happy that we meet again. And this time, there's a long way to go after this. I believe so. And in just few weeks' time, we will be having another of our delivery day or the D-Day seminar. And again, that will test you how matured, how knowledgeable, how professionals are you in delivering the knowledge that I already imparted to you for the past weeks since the beginning of this semester. But what I'm going to tell you today is more on the knowledge that you have to go through after this. The most important part here is the applications on the hands on it and what the real world is all about in your working life. You see, for this semester, I have the most students this time, more than 100 students for both classes. And this is for the first time since I joined operations management program in 2011. I think this is the most very challenging one, but not that really hard for me because I've gone through this case so many times, even when I was in logistics program. So there should not be any hindrance or even a problem for me to handle each of you. But what I'm worried is that if there are many students, the focus will be less. The same case when you one day when you are working, the focus also will be less if there are so many things coming up to you. But what I'm watching here is that is your ability and your focus in tackling the issues, in ensuring that whatever the problems that you are enduring will be soft, and most importantly, you learn from it. This will you will be carried on when you are no longer around here. I always stress that knowledge-wise and everything, whatever that we have over here, okay, it must always start from the universities here. I don't believe that only when you are out from here that you learn. No, it must come from the university itself here. So I hope that during the university time here, don't assume that you are still honeymooning. Most of your students before this, they always think of that. And because of that, when they go for the practical training, they have tons of problems and they could not solve it. Some of them run away from the problems, and majority of them keep on silencing themselves within their own pressure cookers. And lastly, they didn't learn anything. They learn only one thing: the world outside that is very, very challenging, it's very stressful. And because of that, when they finish their studies, they just want to get an easy-going job. But interestingly is that they want highly paid job. Nobody will pay you a highly paid job unless you work hard for it. So where are you going to be after this? Now we are stressing more on the fourth industrial revolution, the 4IR. We are more talking about the machinery, the machines, the robotics, internet ITs, more on the high tech applications with less than manpower. So the structures of the human capital management over here will be more on the skill and high acquisitions of IT in yourself. So what are you going to do now? The fact is very simple. If you don't change, you don't go anywhere. So you have to change here. Change from now. The previous semesters, I always observe all my students, those are your seniors, and I always trust that they can really develop themselves slowly from then onwards, if they work hard. And some of them who did not adhere to my advice, I don't know where they are. But what I heard, they are struggling now. This is not good. Okay, this is not good. We are looking forward and forecast for the next 10 years from now. We don't know what the economics of the country would be. We don't know what will happen. And we don't know the scarcity of the employability in our country. But the fact is, one thing that remains, that if you work hard, there will be no scarcity of the employability. Work hard, gain hard, and you will be very successful. I say here, you are very successful, because only when you work hard, with a little bit of luck, with God's grace, you will be successful. That's what I want you to be. Of course, in my vocabulary in class, there's no such thing as laziness, passengering, depending on other people's, and so on and so on, that is so negatively ever been applied to you before this, maybe. But to me, no such thing over here. Everything is all hard work, work, focus, and the most important part here, don't ever run away from the problem. Don't try to do that. So I drummed this thing here for the past few semesters, and I'm very happy that most of them really take up the challenge, and I heard less complaints now. So for you all here, please look into that thing here too. Okay? Knowledge is very high, it's very wide, it's very deep, and there is no barrier towards how that you want to learn, and go ahead with that thing here. I hope that you'll be very successful in future from now onwards. And what I'm giving you now is just the tips of the iceberg. And you will be receiving more to this when you go outside after you being exonerated out from the university itself. So guys, work hard and remember this. Don't run from the problems. Cheers.